Can you Velvetise Ovaltine? I'm gonna find out. Open the lid. Gosh, that's... Oh no! That's meant to be for that. Never mind. Anyway, this one, you got to use 4 teaspoons. But it doesn't say hooped on the side. It just says 4 teaspoons, so I'm confused. So you can have hooped teaspoons. Oh, I've just spilt a bit of that down the side. I suppose they're still hooped. Milk to the max. Oh, totally in the way of the Camerana. Now we are milk to the max. Turn it on. And turn it on. And it's mixing well. Mixing well. Good, good, good. Got a much better designed cup this time. Who designed this cup much better than the last one? Oh, IKEA. So much the same way as Orlick's, you're supposed to make a paste with this, faff about with a bit of milk, then add the rest of the milk, hot milk, very, very faffy. But if it velvetises, you've saved loads of time. Well, should be nearly done. And it's done. So can you velvetise? Ooh! Looks nice and frothy. Oh, look at that. Has it left a residue in the bottom? No, it has not. So bad looks of it so far, so good you can velvetise Ovaltine. Ovaltine. Smells a lot like Horlicks. Although this one tastes a bit more biscuity. But yeah, it's great. You can velvetise Ovaltine. And I forgot to pick it up. Here we are. So yeah, you can velvetise Ovaltine. Good to know, isn't it? Scratch that in the comment section down below. What you want me to see velvetise next? Or Otcup as well. What do you want to see me Otcup?